this is Diana, also known as Angie's name on Sims, and welcome to my reaction to the Eco Lifestyle trailer. I'm gonna show you a whole bunch of photos and we're gonna talk about everything new that I see, but I have to say I'm really excited about this one. We're going to get a new world that's called Evergreen Harbor, and of course the goal is to make that as clean as possible, or maybe not, depending on what you want. but this pack seems to be full of all kinds of new wonderful outfits, like the ones you see on this photo, and so many new objects. I'm hoping that all the glitter you see in this picture will be available to us, because I know that builders like me and so many wonderful people out there will be able to use this for all kinds of murky and dirty looking lots. And I love the bathtub that you see here, that looks as if it's tumbled down, and the mattress on the floor and all those cans and bottles. And this lady or man, I don't know, this person is definitely wearing new pair of pants and new shoes, and it's all going to be so wonderful. I mean, already just looking at this picture, I see so many new things. I also love the bin bags. They look absolutely gorgeous for bin bags. You know, bin bags don't really look gorgeous in general, but these are nice and green. I can't believe I'm actually happy about bin bags, but hey, it doesn't matter. In the background, you see some trains, some wagons, some industrial looking trains, new boxes, and there's obviously something going on with these bees. He's being attacked by a whole bunch of bees, and it's going to get nasty. So I don't know what is going to happen here, but yeah, it looks very interesting. And we have like those big green I don't know what you call them, containers at the back as well, pizza boxes, so many murky things here. And one of my favorite things is definitely this paper bag that the woman is wearing over her head. It actually has a very surprised expression, like, what the hell is that woman doing in the trash? Why is she doing that? But I just love that. I hope we can have a whole bunch of Sims walking around carrying bags over their heads, because we've never had that before. And I think that's hilarious. Just look at it. I think it's brilliant. And this lovely lady here is showing off a new hairdo, new hat, new shirt, I think, new bracelet, all kinds of new stuff. It looks very interesting. I think I'm gonna like this hairdo. And this lady's actually off to collect the trash and recycle it, which obviously is the whole idea of this eco lifestyle pack. And here we get a first glimpse of some of the new built stuff, like those new walls and the new window. I love these walls already. I can already imagine quite a few builds that I could build using these walls. And I think if I look at this little house, I think this new expansion pack will tie in really nicely with Tiny Living and some of the other packs we had. That's one of the things I actually really enjoy. The last couple of packs, they really tie together quite well. So it is becoming a one wonderful cohesive bunch of packs, really. And I think that's very important. Now here you can already see quite a few very interesting new objects, like the machine the woman is working with. I'll talk about that in a minute, because I've got a few other pictures of this machine. But I'm also very interested in those two, I don't know, bicycles, motorcycles, whatever it is, the mopeds that you see at the back, the orange ones. I can imagine, since this is an eco-living pack, that these are, I don't know, mopeds that run on electricity or something, like e-mopeds or whatever. And I see a very lovely new cupboard at the back, and behind her is something that looks like a new stove, like some wood burner or whatever, something that, you know, burns stuff. Oh, I'm really words, Diana, words. So this is, I think, how this machine works. You put trash in it and you pull a few levers, and then the machine does its thing, and then by magic out pop these blocks of trash that you can reuse, and you can probably build furniture with it or pieces of art or whatever. Anyway, it's a machine that recycles trash. Now, this is another thing that I'm very, very excited about. We can finally make candles. I know that people have been asking for this for quite some time. I think ever since we had Laundry Day, I think one of the options then was making candles or something. And it looks like we're getting it here, together with like a new table you see in the back, in the foreground. In the back, you see a new cupboard. And of course, the machine that she's using to make the candles in is brand new. As is the furniture you see at the back. You can't really see it very well, but I see a coffee table, a new sofa, and a new chair, I think. All kinds of new stuff. I think when it comes to objects and clothing, it's going to be packed with new stuff. I'm very, very excited. And just look at all those lovely new candles. I think all the candles will make for a very nice romantic evening or two. And I think what we see here is one of the unused community spaces that are going to waste and that you can beautify with your neighbours. You can rally your neighbours and decide to turn this into a park or whatever kind of community lot. And yeah, by the looks of it, it's going to take a lot of work. But I love the stuff that I'm seeing here. I love those containers. I actually built a container town some time ago and had to make my own containers, but by the looks of this, I can replace some of them with real containers, so I'm very excited about these as well. And this guy in the middle is obviously rallying his neighbors to do something about his community space. And what I love about this is that, you know, in the back, for instance, you see a wardrobe that we've had in a game since the beginning, and now it looks broken. So, you know, they've reused probably some of the build the objects we already have, and they've broken them, so you know they look all torn and you know used now, which I really, really like. And at the back of the guy there's a board, but I will talk about that in a minute. Everyone in this picture is wearing a new outfit, I think, and I think most of them also actually have a new hairdos, so that looks all very promising. But the outfit I'm most excited about is the dungarees for guys. I've been wanting dungarees for guys for quite some time, and now they finally have it. These hairdos are definitely new, as are the outfits. And I have to say, I really love the look of this. It all looks a bit run down, except for the hair, but the outfits all look a bit run down. And I especially like the hairdo for the guys, but also the blonde one. Yeah, well, actually, I like all three hairdos. Yeah, it looks very, very nice. Now here is that board I was talking about, and apparently this is like an ideas board. So I think if you have an idea, or people can post ideas up here on the board, and then people can actually vote on what idea they like best. So I think you have to write your favorite idea on the little note, put it in the box, and that way you vote for the best idea as to what the community lot should be. Now on this picture you also see quite a few new things. You see a new planter in the back with a little tree in it, and in front of the red container you see a new collection of paintings, so maybe you can sell your paintings. And I think one of the ways the community lots might work is maybe you can turn into a market, because you have all these tables that people use to sell stuff, and I think the tables themselves are new as well. The woman in the front is selling lemonade. Someone is selling food, someone is selling candles, and in the back they're selling bottles and cans or whatever. And again, so many new outfits and a few new hairdos as well. So I think one of the things that you can do with the community spaces is turn into a park or a market, or maybe a store or something. One of the new things that comes with this pack is a new career. There's a new freelance crafter career, and I think all the people here are making new stuff. They probably are recycling all trash, and they are just, you know, making whatever. The red machine is the same as the green one we saw earlier, but I think the woman in the back is working on a new machine, and the guy on the left is as well. I see a few new boxes, a new little, I don't know, end table with wheels. The girls in the back are sitting on new chairs. I see a new plant on the back. There's so many new things here. It's absolutely amazing. This is one of my favorite scenes of the trailer, because I love everything I see here. I love the outfits. I love all the new garden stuff that you see here. But I'm not going to mention everything I see that's new, because it's just, there's just too much. And I'm pretty sure you don't want to sit here for hours on end listening to me rambling on about all the new wonderful stuff in here. And I also think it'll be fun for everyone to discover some of the new stuff on their own. But what I see here, I am absolutely loving it. And look at this guy. He is so happy that the community lot is looking so nice and green. And I have to agree with him. It is really looking beautiful. And here we have an insect form or whatever. At first, I thought when I saw the trailer for the first time and the guy took out this little fluffy yellow thing, I thought it was a little chick, but no, it's a caterpillar, which is just as awesome. Although I know some people already saying that they'd rather have chickens and little chicks and whatnot, but I think an insect form is actually pretty cool, so I'm definitely not complaining. This lovely lady with the lovely new hairdo is working on a new tablet and she is drawing plans to create a machine that will end up looking like a big vacuum cleaner that will just suck up all the nasty stuff in your community or something. I think so. Anyway, here she is putting, programming the machine, and I think it's sort of like a 3D printer or something. And voila, we have this very futuristic kind of vacuum cleaner that will just suck up all the nasty stuff in the air, and maybe that's actually it. Maybe it will just clean the air, or maybe it will just suck up trash. I think it's something to do with the air. I'm not sure, but that's what I think. This little house here, this makes my builder's heart beat quite a bit faster because I see so many new things. I'm not going to name all of it, but let's just have a good look at that ladder. We have a ladder, and I think we are actually going to get that in a free game update. So whether you have the pack or not, you'll get a ladder. I think so. And later in the trailer, you actually see the guy sliding down the ladder. But I'm so happy we're going to get ladders. I think the entire community is screaming ladders at the moment because we've all wanted this for such a long time. But I just love everything. I also love the green roof. And the solar systems. Solar panels. I'm not going to mention every new thing that I see because there's just too much, but I love it all and I can't wait to get my hands on this pack and start building. Now take a look at this neighborhood. It looks so cute. I think they're all, I think the lots will be very small and it will definitely tie in with tiny living because I think these are all tiny houses. Like I said, I can't wait to get my hands on it and rebuild the entire neighborhood because that's what I usually do. And I've got so many ideas already. And we have to wait more than a month. Will we be able to do it? I think we will. But it's going to be difficult. Do you know what? Looking at this picture, I think that the team did a really good job this time because usually people have some complaints about the houses that are already in the game. But this looks like such a lovely neighborhood. People who don't want to build, they can move their Sims right in. You know, the houses look fantastic, to be honest. Now, when you go into the world first time, it will look all brown and ugly. When you clean it up, it will look nice and bright and sunny and colorful. So, yeah, I think you should definitely clean up the town. The building in the back actually looks like a train station, so I'm hoping that it will be sort of like a rabbit hole that you can actually go there and from that train station travel to other worlds or something. I just hope that you can use it for travel. I'm not sure you can, maybe it's just for decoration, it probably is, but it would be wonderful to have a working train station. On the last three pictures you're going to see here, you can see a whole bunch of new objects and hairstyles and whatnot, but I'm not going to talk about that now because you can just have a look at the pictures and discover them for yourself. But what I do want to say is this. I want to talk to you about the Sims community and the reactions the Sims team has been getting these last couple of days. A few weeks ago, the rumor started that the next pack was going to be Farm Life. And personally, I would be very happy with Farm Life. I would love to have some farm animals and whatnot. But then when the leak dropped that I was going to be eco-living, some people were actually quite disappointed. And in a way, I can understand that disappointment. But I think what they're doing now is actually so much better. And some people compared the new upcoming pack with the conservationist career in Solani, and quite a few people said, you know, just having a whole new pack just based on eco living, while we already have Solani, it's just laziness. And I think no, it's most certainly not laziness. If anything, I think is very clever planning, because what we've been seeing the last couple of packs is that the packs are really connected more and more and more. I think with Solani, with the conservationist career, they've given us a taste of, you know, what it's like to actually look after the environment of wherever it is you're living. And even with, you know, Discover University, people have been asking for cars. Instead of cars, we've been getting bikes, which is obviously much better for the environment. And then we've got Tiny Living, which is all also about, you know, leaving a smaller carbon footprint and whatnot. It's about living in smaller spaces, not having too much stuff. And, you know, the smaller you live, the more perks you get. But just by living in the house, one of the perks, I think, is that your electricity bills will be much lower and whatnot. You'll be using less electricity. And now with this pack, they're taking all that even a step further. I think this is going to be quite an in-depth kind of pack. And I don't think it could have come at a better time than now. I think the message that we're all getting is incredibly relevant, very important, and it's such a contemporary topic. You know, we do need to look after a planet much better. And I think it's also a message of hope. Like, come on, people, it's not too late. We've messed up the planet in many, many places, but we can still turn things around, and we have to come together as a community and work on it. And that's one of the reasons why I really love that we are now getting eco lifestyle, because it's so incredibly relevant. And I just can't wait to get my hands on it, not just to build, because, you know, I am a build, although lately I've also been telling lots of stories, but not lately, last couple of years really, but I just want to create a let's play about all of this, you know. So it's I think it's gonna be wonderful. I'm very, very happy that we're getting eco-living. And, you know, also with the new pack that's coming out, we're also going to get a new stuff pack that people voted for. It's also about creating your own stuff. In this case, it's knitting. There are a few options we could choose from, but they all revolved around creating your own stuff and selling stuff, basically using materials you have to create something new. And I know there's also going to be a game pack released sometime this year. And to be quite honest, I would not be surprised if that game pack has something to do with farming. So I think the team is definitely not lazy. I think they have been planning things very well these last couple of years, because the packs are so nicely linked and they're steering the game into a very important new direction. I think it's very realistic, very relative, very contemporary, and I love it. So yeah, I think the Sims team has done a great job so far. And like I said, let's just see, wait and see what this pack really entails. I think it's going to be wonderful. And I can't wait to see what everyone does with it. So these were just my two cents. You don't have to agree with me, but I just wanted to get my opinion out there, because, you know, you don't always get a chance to share these kind of things, right? And I know that people in the community have been asking for all kinds of things, and people sometimes people are very happy with what we're getting, sometimes they're very disappointed, but, you know, they can't please everyone. And I for one am very happy the direction this game is taking, and I hope you'll be too. Anyway, thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed me rambling on about the message and this new pack, and that you'll, you know, come back to my channel for more, because there's so many videos on my channel already, darling. So come have a look, come check them out. Anyway, thanks again for watching, and until next time.